Thank you for stopping by the summit today, and welcome to Midwest Sports Net. I'm Joey McWilliams, and I am extremely pleased to get to be talking about sports once again. And I don't know, I just can't say enough about that. And we're also blessed and privileged to get to have on the summit today the coach from Concordia, whose Bulldogs are 3-0 now overall in the season, 3-0 in GPAC play as well, Coach Patrick Daberkow. And Coach, listen, just talk about that. Not only is it a good thing to talk about sports, but my goodness, you've started the season off well.
Yeah, it's fun to start out 3-0. This profession is very, very rewarding. It's even more rewarding when you win. And so nobody's complaining over here in Seward.
Well, listen, your team has done well, and I know that they're doing well on the strength of a defense that has just stepped it up and even been able to just continue to bring players in when one or two may have to step out with an injury. You're able to fill those spots well. It's a defense that's giving up just a little bit less than 15 points per game. And actually, Coach, you know, one of those scores was a safety. That shouldn't have to go on the defense right there. So we'll just say 14 points a game and talk about that.
Sure. Yeah. Our defense is really two bad run fits away from a rush lane fit and a run fit away from not giving up points in two of those three games as well. So, you know, our defensive coordinator, Corby Osten, and our special teams coordinator, Weston Coombs, who works with our defensive backs, those guys have done a phenomenal job coaching our defense up. And you're going to get a team that likes to play physical. We like to play fast, and we like to finish the football. And I think if you can stick to those formulas, and if you can live that out, I think you're usually going to have success on Saturdays. And so our defense really embodies that. We got great leadership on defense, a lot of guys who walk the walk. It's been fun to see these wins get put together, but also fun to see them play the way they've been playing. And, you know, we still think we haven't hit our ceiling yet with that group, but we're certainly excited about what they've shown.
Speaking now with Coach Patrick Daberkow from Concordia. Coach, you know, we would be remiss if we didn't talk about the offense, I know, at least a little bit, especially when you have the NAI Offensive Player of the Week from a couple of weeks ago in Jonah Wyan, 5 rushing touchdowns in a game. Have you had a chance to see that before?
Nothing comes to the top of my head, you know, as far as coaching. Maybe if we dip back into high school, some of those JV games freshman year, maybe there was somebody. But, man, it's pretty rare that a guy does something like that and an offensive line put something like that together. And so to see Jonah have that kind of success is really rewarding. Jonah is just a really good embodiment of our football program. He's a hard-nosed kid, tough runner, came back from an ACL injury his freshman year and has just really put out this year really good numbers. And it's on the back of a lot of off-season work, a lot of getting with our athletic trainer and our strength coach and getting in the film room. I mean, he's just a great kid all around. And, excited to see the success that he's had.
Coach, you look at three games, of course, 3-0 in GPAC play, and it's just a great way to start a conference schedule anyway. And 2020 is what it is. You know, you're gonna get a lot of conference games in. I'm really excited that you all are playing in the fall. I think that's a great testament not only to your program but to the conference as well, and a shout-out to the GPAC for playing this schedule in the fall. We talk about offense and defense, and there are some numbers that seem to get to be a little more glamorous than others sometime, but one of them that really stands out to me is the fact that you all have had no offensive turnovers through three games. I mean, you're going to win a lot of games if you don't turn the ball over. Talk about how big that is.
Oh, it's huge. You know, I come up from a defensive background. I was the defensive coordinator before I became head coach and was blessed with that job. And 2017 was my first year. One thing that I know is that if you do the simple things right in football, the score usually takes care of itself. And so we pride ourselves in taking care of the ball. But it doesn't mean that we don't take risks. I think that being risk averse is negative. So we still take our risks, and we'll still tuck the ball deep. And we have faith in our wide receivers and our quarterback to make it happen. But the formula of being able to run the football and play great defense and take care of the ball and create takeaways, you know, that's something that's really been something that we harp on. And that's something that has shown out to be true So we're excited about it.
Coach, you look ahead to the schedule, of course, 3-0, and just with the interesting way that 2020's worked out, the team you're going to be facing next on the schedule is yet to start the season. Take on Jamestown this coming Saturday, and then, of course, the rest of the GPAC schedule for you. It doesn't get any easier for you, definitely, from this point on. Talk about the Jimmies and then the rest of your schedule as you look ahead.
Well, Jamestown is a school that has really gotten better over the last 3 years. You know, they've been in our conference. I think this is either year three or year four, and you know, they're an improving football program. We have definitely a vested interest in playing well against them. We went up to Jamestown, North Dakota last year and took a loss in a four overtime game where they were just a tougher team than us, and so we got to own that. We got to look in the mirror and. This is not a game where, you know, you have a lot of information about their current team, you know, going into it with them having not played a game yet and us having three games under our belt. So it certainly isn't a team that we take lightly. You know, we're going to approach this week like we do any other week, and definitely excited for the opportunity to just play football.
All right. Well, success to you then for the remainder of the season, and congratulations so far. 3-0 is Concordia right now. The Bulldogs just rolling to get this season going, and we'll see how they continue along here in 2020. Coach Patrick Daberkow, thank you so much for taking time with us today here on the Summit.
Thank you very much. I appreciate the opportunity.
We appreciate all of you for watching today. And again, I invite you and encourage you, please, to like and share this video. Please do subscribe to the channel, Midwest Sports Net. Again, I'm Joey McWilliams. God bless you. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.